The David Brown Organization loved film. They used it for publicity and promotion. They used it for instruction and training. They used it for entertainment. What they probably never thought about was that they were recording the company history. From that unique record, this is the story of David Brown Tractors on film. David Brown's enthusiasm for film even led them to recreate the meeting in the 1930s at which the founder, David Brown himself, tried to sell the idea of a farm tractor to his staff, with limited success, it seems. However, he pushed ahead with the project, which included an early example of market research. He canvassed farmers, in person, on the phone, and by a postal survey, about what they wanted in a tractor. The result was the famous VAK1, of which over 5,000 were built during the Second World War. The tractor design was modified slightly in the years immediately after the war to produce the 1A, which met with the approval of that famous farming spokesman, A.G. Street, who narrated a promotional film about the merits of tractors in general and the David Brown in particular.
Years ago, I used horses for ploughing. But since 1939, I haven't had one horse on this farm. I've made many experiments, and there's my final choice. A British-made tractor ploughing British land to grow food for British people. Let's take a look at some of the special features. 10 gallons of fuel are sufficient for over 13 hours running under average conditions. Off duty, it might almost be a car traveling to and from work at 18 miles an hour, and with implements attached. So the ploughman no longer plods his weary way to work, at work, or from work. His time is far too valuable to be wasted in walking. Here's an illustration of what David Brown unit principle means. Charlie sets the level. The depth, then the lateral control. Simple, isn't it? And once he sets the correct depth, it stays constant. That's level.